With us now, though, Shannon O'Berski. She's the Director of External Relations for the Meadow Brook Estate. Great to have you with us.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Shannon, you have a beautiful home, but I will say I would love to be kicked back on a couch at Meadow Brook right now in that big estate. It is so regal and so incredibly beautiful.
Yes, I would agree. Of all days, I was disappointed I wasn't able to show you the great background that is Meadow Brook Hall. So today we're settling for my fireplace.
Which your fireplace looks great as well.
All right, thank you. It's not Meadow Brook for sure. Definitely not Meadow Brook.
But, just like a house can really take on like a different setting in the different seasons right now. And with Meadow Brook in the middle of winter and the beautiful snowfall that we're having, it really is a beautiful place to visit.
Absolutely. It's so majestic. We just had some beautiful photos of a bride and groom who got married outdoors at Meadow Brook just this past weekend. And it's beautiful of the bride and groom in front of the house and the snow is just falling. It's picture perfect. So there is something to be said about these kind of cold days, you know, the snow, but there's something about it. It's absolutely beautiful all times of the year.
I'm sure they appreciated the snowfall behind them as well.
I think so too. That really worked out for them.
Or at least their photographer did. Shannon, tell us about some of the events. So are you still able to have weddings and events there at the estate?
So as of right now, we're very limited of what we're able to do due to the current mandates and the limit on gatherings, number of guests who can gather indoors versus outdoors. So we're pretty limited on that still. What we had this past weekend was an outdoor gathering and it did not exceed the capacities. But moving forward, we're pretty quiet right now. We're really optimistic that in the spring and summertime, we'll get back to somewhat normal. And we have a lot of weddings on the books then. But we just, you know, we take each day as it comes, but we're feeling pretty good about it.
I will say, Shannon, kudos to you and your team, because I'm trying to imagine how some of these conversations have gone when the restrictions or mandates come down like the week before a wedding that has been planned for like a year.
Yes, it is.
I would not want to make that phone call.
I will say we have an incredible sales and events team, and they've had to had some very difficult conversations this year, and they've really stepped up and have done an excellent job. But yeah, it's not easy. You know, it's not an easy conversation to have.
But with that, we're all managing during the pandemic. And I know that this past year or in the wintertime, you were trying to do the holiday lights, but that wasn't even able to continue on.
No, unfortunately, due to the mandates and again, the restrictions on gatherings, we weren't able to host the event in the way that we wanted to for our guests to experience it. And so we felt very strongly about that. This was the first year we were launching the program. So we felt very strongly about making sure it was exactly what we wanted it to be, other than a version of what we wanted it to be. So we felt like it made more sense to hold off and relaunch it this year in 2021.
Well, you know what's going to happen this year is we are all going to appreciate things so much more and be so eager to experience some of these events as well. So get ready for the crowd.
Yes, I hope so. I'm counting on it.
But with that, what is going on right now at the Meadow Brook?
So we just did open this February for weekends only. We are offering self-guided touring. This is new. We just opened this the first weekend in February and will be open through February. Guests can tour anytime between 11 a.m. and 4 p.m. with last admittance at 3 o'clock. And we have hosts that are stationed throughout the home, so they can ask any questions they may have while they're touring the home at their own leisure. It's a little different. Obviously, we've made some changes due to the COVID precautions. It being a self-guided tour is one of those changes. Normally, you would get a docent-led tour with a group of folks gathered in one area, and then you would tour through the house. So we've made some changes like that. We also must require guests to purchase tickets online in advance, which also then helps us prepare so that we're not exceeding capacities and we're able to plan as guests are entering the home.
So once they get their ticket online, do they have so much time to actually go through the home?
They can stay as long as they would like. We just ask that the house closes at 4 o'clock. So as soon as they can stay as long as they would like, and plan the visit as long as they would like to stay. It usually takes about an hour to an hour and a half, but with the self-guided, you know, pace, it could be even longer because you can really take your time to look at something a little bit longer. You're not getting, you know, moved along with the group, which is kind of nice.
With that, are you finding that they're selling out because you've had to limit the capacity and so many people are looking for things to do with their family and their kids right now?
Yes, we're actually really pleased. We didn't know what to expect when we made the decision to open the house on the weekends for touring. We've been very pleased. They essentially have sold out every weekend. We cap it at about 100 guests for the duration of the day. And we've been very pleased with the results of that. And I think to your point, people are looking for things to do. They want to get out. It's a safe experience. They're able to enjoy it at their own pace. So we've been very, very pleased with the outcome.
Shannon O'Berski with us here on the MegaCast. She's the Director of External Relations for the Meadow Brook Estate. I know that I've gone online quite a few places and different things looking for things to do. And some of these events are sold out for like weeks in advance. Where do you stand right now on your reservations? Is it pretty much a week or 2 weeks out?
I would say about a week out, although because we've just been open recently, I think we're still getting the word out. I would say folks, as long as they purchase, some of them can even purchase it the day before or even the morning of. We just ask that they do purchase the tickets in advance so we can prepare. And we can sell out, like I said, we're at capacity, but we can manage when people come and go too. So that allows us a little bit of wiggle room, if that makes sense. Once people exit, others can enter.
Shannon, I will say this isn't good for people such as myself. I'm not a planner. I'm a spur of the moment person.
Yep.
And it's really make life hard. Like I went to get tickets for tubing at the farm. You know, they have like the glow lights tubing. It's sold out for the rest of the season. I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I can't even make a hair appointment 2 weeks out.
I know. And it does seem that like with COVID, right? Everything is so extended so much further out. So it will still work for you though, Ronnie, because you can purchase a ticket that morning, right? So that you're not going to lose the opportunity. So you can still be spur of the moment, just purchase it in advance so that we're able to prepare.
That's pushing it, but I'm getting better.
Okay. But how about on the ride over? On the ride over to the hall, then maybe do it there.
There you go. So with that, Shannon, too. So is there anything, like, can they enjoy the outdoor grounds as well? Which I know, you know, right now it is like 0 degrees, but
It is still beautiful. So the grounds are open as well as the hall. They're certainly able to walk around the grounds if they'd like to enjoy that. You know, the paths aren't very groomed or anything prepared for those sort of activities, but they can certainly bundle up, take a walk around the property, look at the exterior of the home, which is also quite beautiful. So there is some, they can do that as well. We also do have an app that's for indoor touring as well as our outdoor touring. So folks, if they just wanted to download the app and just explore outside, they could as well.
But it's a beautiful backdrop to take pictures. So yep. If you wanted to do, you know, now is maybe the time of thinking next year's Christmas card, because when you go to do it and it's November and there's no snow, you want snow, you don't have to Photoshop it.
Yeah, you're right. Because there never is snow when we want it to be, right? It's, you know.
Exactly. See, plan ahead. Think
yep. See?
Shannon O'Berski with us here on the MegaCast. With that, Shannon, too, you just mentioned the app. Does the app also help you if you're doing these self-guided tours to give you background and to talk to you about some of the things that people are seeing?
Absolutely. So we actually launched the app just this past summer when COVID hit, and we were trying to figure out ways that we can continue to engage our audience. So it's been quite successful. So guests now, when they arrive, they can download the app in advance, or they can download it when they arrive to the hall, and they can basically use it to click on a picture of any room that they're in, and it'll give them more information about that room. Sometimes it'll tell a story about the family and how it relates to that room. There'll be historical images as well as current images. So yeah, it gives visitors more of an insight into what they're seeing, especially since they don't have a docent-led tour. It allows them to explore a little bit on their own. And then, like I said, we have hosts that are stationed throughout the home that can answer questions, but this allows them to sort of delve in at whatever pace they would like to.
So, Shannon, do you anticipate concerts are going to be coming back to Meadowbrook at all this next summer?
I absolutely hope so, yes. So we are anticipating and planning for that to start with the summer concert series again. They were very popular last year, and we actually had them through the fall as well. Because of COVID, they had a very positive response. So we do have them on the books, so to speak, planning to proceed with them in June if we're able to. It's an outdoor concert, so we're very hopeful that it shouldn't be a problem.
It's one of the best venues to go see a concert. The older I get, I no longer like to go like to Ford Field, yeah. or well, it used to be the Palace too, and now that that's gone. But I like the smaller, more intimate concerts. I think they're so much more enjoyable. But with that, do you anticipate? I know it's early on, but the possibility of having to require people to either have the vaccine or to have a negative test to come on and enjoy your venue at all?
That's a good question. I don't know quite what to expect just yet. Now, currently we are making them, we are requiring that they fill out the health forms before they enter the estate property. But other than that, I don't know what to expect. I know I'm optimistic that if the vaccines come out and we're able to get people on the property, and if we need to do that, we will. But as of right now, just like all of us, it's just so much is unknown. As of right now, the health forms is sort of a new thing that we've been doing over the last year, and that seems to be helpful, and the public seems to receive it just fine. So as long as people are willing to do what it takes in order to protect a community and each other, then we'll do that as well.
Yeah, it really is going to be a crazy year that we have to continue to navigate, because even though we have a vaccine, it's like you said, there are so many unknowns, but I think they're even talking about now an app. So like if you're going to fly, you could show that you had the vaccine.
Oh, that's interesting.
It kind of like that Clear app. I don't know if you use Clear when you travel, but you could also use it to go to like the Tigers games and some of those as well. So instead of the advanced security, it will show that you've had the vaccine or maybe a negative COVID test within so many days. I think it's just going to be kind of how we operate in the next year.
No, it's very surreal how things have changed and how we've just gotten used to it. And we just adapt and we continue to, forge ahead.
I know. And with that, still no problems, though, from the public, right? We all know now, 11 months into this, you're going to wear a mask. it's like, it just is what it is.
It is what it is. And, and quite frankly, at the beginning of all this, we were concerned about that. We didn't know how people were going to respond, if they were going to want to come and tour, if we had all these expectations placed upon them. But we've had no problems, and we're really grateful for that. Now guests are required to wear masks when they enter. They have to complete the health form. We have hand sanitizer stations throughout the home. The touring route is a one-way route, different entrances and exits for guests. So we have implemented all the precautions, and people seem to be embracing it, and we've had no issues, thankfully.
Yeah, and really the good thing at this point in time within the pandemic, we're not seeing the supply issues that we had in the beginning. You can find a mask anywhere. You can find hand sanitizer. Clorox wipes are back.
So. Yes, I do remember that if you saw them at the store, they were always gone, and now they're back in abundance. You're right.
Right. There was that little surge where toilet paper started to be empty again. In the summer, it was like, wait a minute, did we already learn? It's okay. We're going to have enough.
It is funny. Group psychology of all of it. It is very funny, but we've been great about that. We've been thankful for that. And the fact too, like masks, to your point, like everything's branded now. We even thought, should we get a Meadow Brook Estate mask? I mean, that seems to be the thing. So who knows?
Most definitely. It's like you said, it's just kind of the way. And now you buy a mask to match your outfit. So.
I know, right? You coordinate them. Who would have thought?
Right. Well, Shannon, it's been great having you with us. Quickly, though, before we let you go, is there anything maybe I didn't touch on that you want to share with our listeners and viewers before we say goodbye?
Oh, sure. I would love for you to come take a tour. Please visit our website, meadowbrookhall.org. You can purchase tickets in advance. We're opened in the weekends on February from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. And check back on our website for touring dates coming through the spring, March on through the spring.
And it really is quite beautiful there in the wintertime, and it makes for an amazing backdrop if anyone wants to go and maybe do some pictures in the middle of winter. Enjoy the snow while we have it.
Right, exactly. Right.
Well, Shannon, thanks again for your time. We appreciate it.